Day to everyone. I'm going to discuss one of the three branches of government, which is the legislative department or the lawmaking body.
The legislative department is under the Congress of the Philippines, which consists of Philippine Senate and the House of Representatives. So these are the logos of Philippine Senate and the House of Representatives. The members of the Philippine Senate. The members of the House of Representatives.
Our objective in this lesson is to discuss the roles and responsibilities of Philippine Senate and House of Representatives.
To know your knowledge about the lesson, let's take the pretest first. For question number one, how many members are there in Philippine Senate? A. 12 B. 20 C. 22 D. 24 Time's up! The correct answer is letter D. 24 For question number 2, what is the highest position in the House of Representatives? A. President B. House Speaker C. Majority Floor Leader Time is up. B. House Speaker is the correct answer. For question number 3, what is the highest position in the Senate of the Philippines? A. House Speaker B. President C. Senate Sergeant at Arms Time is up. B. President is the correct answer. In a republic democratic type of government, the power is divided into three co-equal branches. The executive branch, which is headed by the president, they have the power to execute laws. The judiciary department, which is headed by the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, they have the power to interpret laws. While the legislative branch, they are the lawmaking body. According to the 1987 Constitution, legislative power shall be vested in the Congress of the Philippines, which shall consist of a Senate and a House of Representatives. The Senate of the Philippines is headed by the Senate President. Currently, Vicente Tito Soto III is the Senate President of the Philippines. The Senate shall be composed of 24 senators who shall be elected at large by the qualified voters of the Philippines as may be provided by the law. The current senators are Leila De Lima, Franklin Drilon, Sherwin Gatchalian, Richard Gordon, Risa Ontiveros, Panfilo Lacson, Manny Pacquiao, Francis Pangilinan, Ralph Recto, Vicente Soto, Joel Villanueva, Juan Miguel Subiri, Sonny Angara, Nancy Binay, Pia Cayetano, Ronald De La Rosa, Bongo, Lito Lapid, Amy Marcos, Coco Pimentel, Grace Po, Bong Revilla, Francis Tolentino, and Cynthia Villar. The highest position in the House of Representatives is the Speaker of the House. At present, Lord Alan Velasco is the House Speaker. The House of Representatives shall be composed of not more than 250 unless otherwise fixed by law, 20% of whom must be party list representatives. These are the qualifications of senator. Number 1, a natural-born citizen of the Philippines. Your father and your mother must be a Philippine citizen and you were born in the Philippines. Number 2, at least 35 years old. Senator Benigno Aquino Jr. was the youngest elected senator of the Philippines. Number 3, must be able to read and write. There's no educational requirement for the senator as long as you are able to read and write. Number 4, a registered voter, and number 5, a resident of the Philippines for not less than 2 years before election day. Here are the qualifications of the member of the House of Representatives. Number 1, a natural-born citizen of the Philippines. Number 2, at least 25 years old. Number 3, must be able to read and write. Number 4, except the party list representatives, a registered voter, and a resident for at least 1 year in the districts where he or she shall be elected. A senator may serve up to 6 years. For example, in 2016, you won in the senatorial race. Your term of office will end in 2022. No senator may serve more than 2 consecutive terms. For example, in 2016, you won in the senatorial race and your term will end in 2022. In 2022, you run again for the same position and you won again. Your term of office will end in 2028, that is already 2 consecutive terms or a total of 12 years. And by the law, you are not allowed to run again because that is already more than 2 consecutive terms. The members of the House of Representatives may serve up to 3 years. 1 term is equivalent to 3 years. The members of the House of Representatives may serve up to 3 consecutive terms or a total of 9 years. The President has the power to appoint his cabinet secretaries, head of bureaus, and other government agencies, including military officials, but it requires appointments coming from the Commission on Appointments. The Commission on Appointments, it is consists of the President of the Senate as ex officio chairman, 12 senators, and 12 members of the House of Representatives. The chairman of the commission shall not vote except in case of a tie. The commission shall act on all appointments submitted to it within 30 session days of the Congress from their submission. The commission shall rule by a majority vote of all the members. The Congress shall have the sole power to declare the existence of a state of war. It requires 2/3 of vote from both houses in joint session assembled, voting separately. The Senate or the House of Representatives or any of its respective committees may conduct inquiries in aid of legislation in accordance with its duly published rules of procedure. The rights of persons appearing in or affected by such inquiries shall be respected. The Senate and the House of Representatives shall each have an electoral tribunal which shall be the sole judge of all contests relating to the election returns and qualifications of their respective members. Each electoral tribunal shall be composed of 9 members, 3 of whom shall be justices of the Supreme Court to be designated by the Chief Justice, and the remaining 6 shall be the members of the Senate or the House of Representatives. The Congress will act as Board of Canvassers for presidential and vice presidential votes. For our performance task, you are the representative or the congressman in Malabon. As a public servant, you are tasked to propose a bill or law on how to improve the English proficiency level of the students. In crafting your bill or law, you'll have to consider the following. Number 1, what are the benefits of this law to the students if you are fluent in English? Number 2, what are the policies or measures to be considered once the bill law was passed? Number 3, what would be the consequences if you violated this bill or law? Remember that you are going to pass this performance task in our next meeting. To determine your knowledge about the lesson, get your pen and paper and take the short quiz. For number one question, what is the power of legislative branch? A. Law-making body. B. To interpret laws. C. To execute laws. Number two, who has the sole power to declare the existence of war? A. Congress of the Philippines. B. Senate of the Philippines. C. House of Representatives. What is the minimum age requirement for a senator? A. 25. B. 30. C. 35. This is the end of our quiz.
That's all for today, and have a nice day. See you next meeting.